Hey, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to this 12-volt, 100-amp-hour lithium iron phosphate battery from Redodo, which has low temperature charging protection. It's being marketed as a trolley motor battery, but it can be used for much more. I'll be explaining what low temperature charging protection is. Then I'm going to run this battery through a variety of tests, including a test which verifies that the low temperature charging protection actually works. Then I'm going to tear this battery down so we can take a look at the inside. I'll spare you from watching me pull everything out of the box. Instead, I'll quickly go through this really good image here I found on Redodo's website, which does match exactly what came in the box I received. So you see here we have the battery. It's a group 31 size battery. It comes with two insulating caps and two M8 terminal bolts. It comes with a product manual, it comes with stickers, and a guide guard. As you can see, it's 13 inches long. It's 8.43 inches tall and it's 6.77 inches deep, and it comes in at a weight of 22 pounds. Okay, let's take a closer look at the actual battery. This is your typical 12.8 volt 100 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery, but with the added low temperature charge protection as indicated here. And it also mentions trolling motors over there. I'll talk a little bit about trolling motors later and some information about that. It is enclosed in this ABS plastic case with an IP65 waterproof rating, which just means it's dust tight and it's protected against water being projected from a nozzle. This battery does have these epoxied in terminals marked here red and a little plus sign, and the negative has a black and a little negative sign. This battery did arrive at a good voltage. It was 13.12, which just means that Redodo is storing and shipping their batteries out at the optimum voltage for long-term storage. Okay, before I talk about what low temperature charger protection is, and you already know all about that subject, you can feel free to use the YouTube chapters to skip to the next section. So what is low temperature charging protection on these lithium iron phosphate batteries? It's basically just a feature of the BMS to protect the battery against damaging itself. Lithium iron phosphate batteries should not be charged when the internal battery cell temperature is below freezing. If you do, you'll almost certainly cause permanent damage to the battery and possibly even create a short. You can still use the battery in freezing conditions, down to -4 according to the manual. You just don't want to charge it when the battery is at those temperatures. Now, if I were to take this battery outside right now, and it was, let's say it was 0 degrees outside, I can still charge it at that point. The inside battery cells have not yet had time to drop below freezing. It's only when the actual cells have reached that temperature that you can't charge it. So, the inside of these batteries here, there is a little temperature sensor, and it's mounted directly against the battery cells. That measures the temperature, and the BMS will shut it off, shut off charging if they reach below freezing temperatures. And I'll be testing that in just a minute. When the battery warms back up, the BMS will allow you to charge again. The owner's manual states when it gets down to below 32, which is freezing, it will shut off charging, and when it reaches back up to 41 degrees, it will allow charging again. So if you have a situation where you need to charge a lithium iron phosphate battery, that gets below freezing conditions for some periods of time, you may want to check out a battery like this. There are also other types of low temperature charging protections. Some batteries actually have heating pads inside. Those batteries are called self-heating batteries. However, that does use some of the battery's capacity just to keep the battery warm. There are also some solar charge controllers out there that have low temperature charging protection. Even if your battery doesn't have that feature, your solar charger controller does, and if the temperature drops below freezing, it won't charge your battery. Okay, so regarding this battery being used as a trolling motor, trolling motors often come with this feature of low temperature charging protection because they are in below freezing conditions in a lot of cases. Lithium iron phosphate batteries have advantages over lead acid batteries. Well, first, they're one-third the weight, and you can discharge these almost down to zero while maintaining full power. Lead acid batteries can only be discharged into about 50% before you start actually damaging the batteries. Lithium iron phosphate typically lasts 10 years or more, and lead acid typically lasts 3 to 5 years. So trolling motors, they come in 12, 24, and 36 volts. Maybe others, I'm not sure. But this battery is, of course, a 12 volt battery. But you can wire two of these in series to get 24 volt, or three in series to come up with a 36 volt battery bank. This one 12 volt battery can produce up to 70 pounds of thrust in a trolling motor. Two in series can produce up to 100 pounds, and three in series for 36 volts can produce up to 120 pounds of thrust. This battery does have a continuous output rating of 100 amps, and the manual says it can go up to 300 amps for 5 seconds, which could be useful for starting up some trolling motors. If you are still using lead acid batteries with your trolling motor, you may want to take a look at a lithium iron phosphate battery like this. Okay, we're going to do a little max load test here using my 12 volt DIY solar generator I built. I'm going to use the space heater over here and the heat gun to dial it in just a little over 100 amps and run it for 5 minutes. To 26, let's turn on the heat gun. To 56, 76. We are now up to just a little over 100 amps. Okay. Let's turn it down just a little. Okay, got it just a little over 100 amps here. Let's run for 5 minutes. Okay, I passed that test with no problem. Okay, now I'm gonna crank it up to about 110 amps and let's see what happens. How long it'll do that. The inverter fans are running. Okay, I did that for a full minute. Let's crank it up to 120 amps and see what happens. Okay, it shut us down. And we know it was the battery because the inverter totally turned off. And so it ran about, I think that was around 20 seconds at 120 amps. Okay, so after about 10 to 15 seconds, the battery cut back on and started powering things again. After charging up the battery and then letting it rest overnight, I did a battery capacity test. I set the tester to draw about 10 amps and then I let it run. When the test completed, this Redodo battery came in at 104.76 amp hours, which is a little over the 100 amp hour rated capacity, so that's a pass. As you watch me struggle to tear down this battery, if you are enjoying this review video, please like the video so YouTube will show it to more people. And if you're not already a subscriber and you enjoy content like this, please consider subscribing. Okay, I finally got that battery open. Let's take a look inside. I'm going to try to get this out, pull it out in just a second. Let's look around before I try. I think that white wire there is the temperature sensor, and this red one here is the overheat sensor, and the looks like the BMS is a Starry C. I think I've heard of that, but I'm not really familiar with them. Please leave in the comments if you are. So let's see if I can get this out of here. Okay, I got it pulled out, and that was not easy. First thing I'll show you here is I found the temperature sensor or probe. There's a black wire, it's kind of hard to see right there, that runs down through there. There's some tape, and there's a little probe right there. And we'll be checking that in a minute. So here are the battery cells, and I did scan these, and all four of them came back as great power, and they're all made on the same day. And here's the screenshots of those. And so that's good, made on the same day. I'm not familiar with great power. If you're familiar with great power, please put it down in the comments what kind of brand that is. I'm not familiar if that's a good brand or not. So here's another shot of the BMS from the top. Again, it's the REC. I'm not familiar with that. If you are, please put down in the comments what you know about that brand. I saw another review of the same battery, and it was a Redodo branded BMS. Thought I'd just do a little 360 here of this internal battery, of the battery here. Zoom in here. Should just take that off, but I didn't. That's just remnants of where I ripped off the that high density foam. It was stuck to it really good. Okay, so let's check the cold temperature charging protection. I've got the battery charger hooked up. It's currently charging right now. And I've got the little sensor, temperature sensor pulled away. So let's spray it here and bring the temperature down. And it turned right off. Good. Let's see if we can warm it up. And that is cold. And it should warm up here and start charging again. And there it goes. So the cold temperature charging protection does work. But I'm going to take it a step further and just see how, what temperature does this actually turn on. Okay, so we have the battery charging currently. I have a glass of ice water here that's very cold. I don't know if you can see that, but it is just below, right at 30 degrees, 31. Almost start, just it got below 30 there, 28, 29. So let's see if that probe will turn off at that temperature. Turn off the charging at that temperature. Come on. And there it worked. So that means it doesn't have to get all the way to zero or something to actually work. So it did work just below freezing. And it's already cut back on for me touching it and warming it up. So temperature charging, low temperature charging protection does work. So what are my final thoughts about this battery? Well, Redodo has definitely created a high quality battery with low temperature charge protection. I would definitely recommend this battery. It performed very well in my testing. And as you saw, it also has a high quality internal build. The testing showed that the BMS is also high quality because it shut down when overloaded and when the temperature dropped to just below freezing, just as advertised. But I'm not familiar with the battery sales brand, Great Power, or the BMS brand, StarEC. So I know I've mentioned this a couple of times, but please leave comments if you're familiar with those brands and know something about them. We can all learn from that. Redodo does back this battery up with a 5-year warranty. At the time I'm filming this video, the price on this battery is $229 on Redodo's website, which is typically a good price for a battery with low temperature charging protection. However, if you're watching this video before or during the Amazon Summer 2024 Prime Day event coming up in just a few days, the price on this battery will be down to $215.99 from July 8th to the 18th, I believe. I believe these prices will be the same on Redodo's website. I do have a discount code I'll put down in the video description that would typically save you 5% any other time of year, but for the month of July 2024, this discount code will be 6%. I'm not exactly sure how a discount code will work with these prices, so you just have to try it out to see what you can save. So if my understanding is correct though, that means if you purchase this battery from Redodo's website and using my discount code, you can pick this low temperature charging protection battery up for an amazing price of just $203. Oh, and that's with free shipping. I was paying more than that for similar batteries without low temperature charging protection just about a year ago. Redodo is also offering even additional discounts if you buy more. I think you can save something like $15 off if you order $500 or more, or $40 off if you order $1,000 or more. So there may be even more levels. So just go check out their website during the sales event and see what you can save. Oh, I'm also going to put my affiliate links below in the description. And remember, those links won't cost you a penny more. But it really helps my channel out. I get a small commission and it helps my channel produce more videos just like this one. Well, I really hope you enjoyed this video review. I also appreciate that you made it all the way to the end of the video. And thank you very much for watching.